There's concern, though. I mean, their livelihood is at stake.
Forest River is as low as I've ever seen it. Park River is much further behind.
They say if you're seeding into dust, your crop will become dust. Watching the cedars go through and it's just clouds of dust, you can't even see the cedar.
NDSU extension agents have been playing a critical role in monitoring drought conditions across the state. The drought monitor maps are used to determine the need for a drought disaster designation, and that designation triggers federal assistance programs. That information is also used by decision makers at the state level to determine needs for additional assistance for those farmers and ranchers being impacted by drought.
It is my job to provide feedback from my state to the drought monitor author. Really, nothing beats the local experts' opinion of what the climate and the drought is doing in the local fields. And because of that, we rely on county agents, and they are the most knowledgeable entity in the state. They know their producers, they know their area. They go out every day, they take pictures, they take notes. If I zoom out, and you can kind of see how many reports are you reported in the United States. And you will see that week after week, North Dakota has been reporting more often than many other states. So the National Drought Mitigation Center, who makes this map, shows North Dakota as an example.
We're sending in photographs. We're sending in evaluations of our crop situations. We're sending in reports on livestock sales, reports on forage shortages.
If I'm doing something else in a different part of the county, I'm taking notes and trying to document what I'm seeing. I do also work with producers in different areas of our county to give me input and feedback and sending me pictures also.
Making sure when I am out, I'm talking with people and hearing what they're seeing out in the field too. Using my committees too that I have to bounce what I'm seeing myself and making sure accurately reported and documented that way too. That way we can help them out as much as we can.
This is also archived, and it is going to be preserved forever. And 10 years later, if I am making a research and I wanted to look what D4 looks like, I would have the ability to compile all that information and make a comparison. I wish we had that ability during the previous drought. I wish we had that in 1930s, 1980s. I would have the ability to compare 2020, 2021 drought with 1930s drought, 1980s. These questions keep coming.
I can tell them what we did 30 years ago and how we tried to maintain our cow herd and what we did with our hay and what we did to keep things from blowing. And that was an experience I never thought I would use again, but unfortunately I am. We have to talk about how things are, what the probabilities are, but let's not dwell on the down things. We need to have hope, and we need to have optimism, and we need to keep the right attitude.
Mm-hmm.